Medikit St. Louis is here with the top five table tips. I'm going to say for kids, but we got to say, yeah, I mean, good manner starts with the parents.
Okay, this is for everybody. We've all been sitting at that table and somebody is so loud or so obnoxious, or we just have to sit there and say, I am so tired of seeing someone else's chewed up food. It's just, it goes with that concept of everybody's thinking within themselves. They don't think about how anything impacts others. So table manner starts with what mom and dad teach the kids at home. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, the problem most moms say to me is, but he went off to school. You know, he was fine when he was five. And then he went to kindergarten or first grade, and they sat at the school lunch table, and everything was gone.
He lost his mind.
It was gone. Right.
Okay. First off, and so many kids do this, and this is the whole shovel.
Okay.
Shovel food into their mouth.
Yes. We want to hold our utensil like a pencil. We always teach kids kind of similar to a pencil, not like a shovel, and we tell them it's not a weapon. So there's none of this stuff going on. So when we hold it like a pencil, I mean, and kids shovel, adults shovel. I will be at a corporate dinner for 100 professionals, and there is someone shoveling. So that is a huge deal. Guarding is another one.
Yeah, and this
it's
is,
this.
Yeah.
Okay, but you cannot take my food, as if your big brother's really going to steal your food, and he might.
He might, oh yeah.
But we can't take that skill outside of the home, and parents need to encourage siblings to not take food off of each other's plates so that we can quit that guarding habit. Uh-huh. And I'm hearing that habit is really instilled more in middle school because kids at that middle school age are playing more jokes at the lunch table, taking this snack and taking that thing. And so kids really do start that. It's almost a real sense of guarding. And so we just have to stop those things at the table so our kids don't grow up, become professionals who guard and shovel at the same time.
Also huge, take small bites. I've gone through this with all my kids.
You know, our life has gotten so fast. Everything is so fast-paced, so we're taking large bites. We're eating quickly. We're trying to rush to get to the next thing. And school lunches, honestly, again, going back to those, they're quick, 20 minutes, 25 minutes. And so we have to take small bites and be aware of the size of the bite. And if it's so big that we're having to maneuver to get it into our mouth, probably too big.
It's a problem.
Probably too big.
All right. In the big one, we hear this all the time, but it still plays true. Do not talk with food in your mouth.
Oh, you would think, right, that people know this. And some people say, oh, I'm not going to talk, but maybe they're just a loud eater. There's all these noises with the tongue and the lips and the utensils and scraping with our teeth. And so regardless, if you listen to yourself eat or even have someone else listen to you, and if you're making excessive noises, whether it's talking with food in your mouth or smacking your lips or moving your tongue in a funny way, then, you know, maybe you need to look at how you can minimize your eating noise.
All right. Lastly is slow down, which I think that's self-explanatory.
Yes.
And I want you to get real quickly about your etiquette boot camp.
We have an etiquette boot camp coming up June 28th, Missouri Baptist, kids ages 5 to 12. It's going to be from 9 to 11 in the mornings, and it's going to be a lot of fun. Fun ways to learn good table manners and more.
All right. Melanie Broyles, Etiquette St. Louis, thank you so much. For more information about her etiquette boot camp, head to stlmoms.com. I'm going to send you there, JB. Etiquette boot camp, my friend.
I'm good.
We both might need to sign up.